Hello students, so next we will consider recombinant DNA. So recombinant DNA is commonly used in the technology which is called recombinant DNA technology. So what is this recombinant DNA? Here recombinant means the DNA which is having a foreign gene, right? It is called recombinant DNA. So here the DNA which is taken, it is the plasmid, right? So plasmid is a DNA, a circular DNA. In that, a foreign gene is fitted or inserted. Then you get this recombinant DNA. So plasmid plus the desired gene, right? Plasmid plus desired gene, you get the recombinant DNA, right? So recombinant DNA is the DNA formed when a desired gene is inserted in the plasmid. So plasmid, when it has a desired gene, you get recombinant DNA. So the first recombinant DNA was constructed, right? The first recombinant DNA, the first recombinant DNA was constructed, or we can say prepared, it was prepared by the two scientists. They are Cohen and Boyer. So Cohen and Boyer were the first to construct a recombinant DNA. So Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer, they constructed the first recombinant DNA. So for this, they used the plasmid. They used the plasmid from a bacteria. They used plasmid from a bacterium, that is from a bacterium called Salmonella typhimurium, right? So from this bacterium, Salmonella typhimurium, they used the plasmid and they constructed the first recombinant DNA. So here you may expect questions. Who first constructed the recombinant DNA? So the answer is Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer. Another question you can expect: the first recombinant DNA was constructed by using the plasmid from which bacterium? So the first recombinant DNA was constructed by using plasmid from a bacterium called Salmonella typhimurium. So from this bacterium, they took the plasmid and they constructed the first recombinant DNA. So to construct a recombinant DNA, what are the requirements, what you require? So the first requirement is the plasmid. So a plasmid is required. Then you require restriction enzymes and DNA ligase. So to construct a recombinant DNA, a plasmid is required, then restriction enzymes are required, and DNA ligase. This is also another enzyme. So all these are required. So first we shall consider a plasmid. So what do you understand by this term plasmid? So plasmid, it is a circular, autonomously replicating DNA that is found in the bacterial cells. So plasmid is circular, autonomously replicating DNA, which is found in the bacterial cells. So one mark question, what is a plasmid? So you are right, plasmid is circular, autonomously replicating DNA found in bacterial cells. Autonomously replicating means, autonomously means self-replicating. Self-replicating means it replicates independently, right? Plasmids, they replicate independently. The meaning of replication, replication means to multiply, right? DNA replication, already I've studied. So DNA replication means multiplication of DNA. One DNA molecule produces two DNA molecules, right? It is called replication. So it is self-replicating, or it replicates independently. The structure is circular, right? So plasmids are circular, like this. So plasmid is circular, it is autonomously replicating DNA found in bacterial cells. So I have drawn a bacterial cell. So we shall imagine this as the E. coli bacterium. Here E. coli, that is Escherichia coli. So this is the generic name, that is genus, and this is species. This can be abbreviated to E. coli, right? So E. coli is a bacterium that is commonly used in the biotechnology labs. So this is the structure of this bacterium E. coli. Now in this bacterial cell, this is the plasmid. What about this? This is the bacterial DNA, right? This is the bacterial DNA, and this is the plasmid. This bacterial DNA, we can call it as nucleus also. So this is the nucleus, but here nuclear membrane is absent. You don't find nuclear membrane, right? That's why this is a false nucleus, and this cell is a prokaryotic cell. So this is the bacterial DNA. This is the additional DNA present in the bacteria. So this is additional DNA, right? Extra chromosomal. So this is additional DNA, which is circular, and that is called plasmid. So just remember, plasmid is circular. It is found in the bacterial cells. And the important feature of plasmid is, it is autonomously replicating DNA. Means it replicates independently. It doesn't depend on this bacterial DNA for replication, right? So without depending on bacterial DNA, it replicates. That's why it's called autonomously replicating, right? Now these plasmids, they are commonly used in the recombinant DNA technology or in biotechnology, right? In biotechnology, plasmids are commonly used for gene cloning. So this plasmid from the bacterial cells, it is used in gene cloning. So the next requirement we shall consider is the restriction enzymes. So restriction enzymes, these enzymes, they are commonly used for cutting the DNA. So it is just like a scissor. What is the use of scissor? Scissor is used for cutting paper. So you cut paper with the help of scissors, right? So DNA is cut by using these enzymes, which are called restriction enzymes. And the example for this restriction enzyme is REN. Right? So REN is the example of restriction enzyme. So details we shall discuss in the coming videos. So the full form of REN is restriction restriction endonuclease, right? So restriction endonuclease is a type of restriction enzyme which is used to cut DNA. Fine. Then DNA ligase is another enzyme. So what is the function of this DNA ligase? It is used to join the two cut ends of DNA. So imagine this is one cut end of DNA and imagine this is another cut end of DNA. So these two cut ends, they are joined like this. So joining two cut ends of DNA like this is with the help of a gum or a glue, which is DNA ligase. So DNA ligase, it is just like a gum or a glue, which is used to join the two cut ends of DNA, right? So to construct a recombinant DNA, these are the requirements. So you require a plasmid, then restriction enzymes, and another enzyme called DNA ligase. So that is about the recombinant DNA. Fine. So we shall revise it in brief. So recombinant DNA is the combination of desired gene and plasmid. What is this desired gene? What do you mean by this desired gene? The gene which you want to clone, right? Or we can say selected gene. The gene that you select, right? The gene that you select, it is called desired gene. It is also called gene of interest. Right? So desired gene, selected gene, or gene of interest. So this gene, right, this gene, it is fitted in a plasmid, right? So plasmids are commonly found in different bacteria. So we shall consider this as a plasmid. Right, so consider this as a plasmid. This has the desired gene, right? So this is the plasmid and this is the desired gene. So if you want to construct a recombinant DNA, what is done? First, you have to cut this, you have to cut the plasmid, So this plasmid, is cut. See, a plasmid is basically DNA only, right? Plasmid, it is the DNA found in bacterial cells. So this DNA, that is plasmid, is cut. How it is cut? By using enzyme. So which enzyme is used? The enzyme used is this RE, restriction enzyme. So now what happens? When you treat the plasmid with RE or restriction enzyme, that plasmid is cut. Now it becomes open. Initially it was closed, right? Initially it was closed, now it is open. Now you can say it is open. Next, what is done? This desired gene, is inserted in the, it is fitted in the plasmid. Like this. Fine. So this desired gene or gene of interest or selected gene is fitted in the plasmid, or it is inserted in the plasmid. So this end of plasmid and this end of desired gene, how they are linked or how they are fixed, it is with the help of another enzyme called DNA ligase. Whereas this end of plasmid and this end of desired gene, they are again joined, right? They are joined together by ligase. Fine. So in this way you obtain a molecule that is called recombinant DNA. So recombinant DNA is the combination of plasmid and the desired gene. So this is a recombinant DNA. So the first recombinant DNA was constructed by Stanley, Cohen and Herbert Boyer by using the plasmid of a bacterium called Salmonella typhi murium. Right? So that is about the recombinant DNA and how it is constructed. So we shall conclude here and we shall continue in the next video. Thank you.